Kid Factory fans, it's Simon Papa Smurf. This is my new little friend, Sunny, because of the orange cheeks. Very cute little cockatiel we got a couple months ago. It's just starting to be a pretty good bird. It has days where it's absolutely horrible, and days like today where it's pretty cute. I guess it's adjusting to a new life. So anyways, I haven't uploaded anything lately because, frankly, I've just been taking a break. And if you remember, oh, the hair is terrible. Where's the hairdresser? Like we have the budget. 23 years nonstop, and I decided to take a break. I turned 63 a few months ago and all that. I've had to deal with a couple of health issues that come up. Oh, joy. The little terrorist is going to go to work. And I have been working on one thing. I do have the big Yamato 1/350th planned soon. And that's going to be the next project. Again, not for sale, but available. But for my collection, I just got to put up another shelf because I'm quite out of room. Don't attack anything. Can be quite destructive. Gary Stare, a very good friend and a client, sent me this terrific 3D printer sculpture of a massive table with some of the stuff that I've built over the years. Very clever. And a representation of moi, which, you know, the more I look at it, the more I see the resemblance. Although it has cheekbones from many years ago. Stop that. But not bad, actually. And I'm going to do my best to give it a good paint covering and detailing. But the whole thing looks something like me proudly standing behind my creations. Very, very cool. And I'm going to be flashing pictures here and there of what it looked like of the first few stages. I wish I'd have captured those beforehand. But this is a catch-up film. You got to stop that. You're being annoying. Yes, you are. Terrorist, I tell you. And I had second thoughts about bringing her, but she's still here. She's usually pretty good with me. My wife is the bird person, and I'm not really, although they're very cute. And this one's bonding with me instead of my wife, much to my chagrin. Anyway, so now I'm going to do a little airbrushing, and I'm going to do the unveil after I do that, which is the three primary colors on the table are laid out, and then the primary colors on each of these are laid out. One's the Icarus from Planet of the Apes. One is the Spindrift from Land of the Giants. One is the Enterprise Classic. This one here is the little Chariot from Lost in Space, and obviously the Jupiter 2, which I made a lot of along with the Enterprises. And kind of a fun thing, personal. It's going to go up on my little shelf up here where I keep some stuff that's really not for sale, just for fun. And I hated to see it just in 3D plastic printed without any detail at all. So I thought it'd be worth doing as a warm up to, you know, get back the feel of it, because I haven't built in a couple months for that big Yamato, which I'll show you. And I did a video that many years ago. And that's how long it's been up there, because it's a tricky bastard. It's electronics and all kinds of stuff. These little tiny, all the guns work, and there's lighting and all kinds of goofy stuff. A lot of people don't paint it. I will paint it. I've seen some very good examples online. Some people have done a terrific job with it. And we'll move on from here. It's only a quick catch-up film to tell you, hey, I'm not dead, you know, and everything's great. And it has been a relief. I've got some things done. I've kind of lounged around, sloughed off a lot. And that's okay. Retirement's meant to be retirement, but I don't like sitting around very long, and I'm there. So in early, let's see, January of this coming year, 24, we're going to get into it slowly. I'm not on schedule anymore. And I don't really get gigs anymore, you know, now that I'm old and all that. Nobody thinks of old Papa Smurf. I had to take down the website. Wix websites was overcharging, doubling the price every so often. And I was just like, that's it. I'm done being extorted from. And I may set up some little thing, more of a gallery style eventually. But for now, I'm off there. And YouTube is probably the only place you can catch any of my stuff. And there's 512 something videos on there, so you can see plenty of what I did when I was a far younger boy. But I'm not dead yet, as I said. All right, so let's move on. I'm gonna do a little airbrushing, do the unveil, show you just the early beginnings of this little project, this little starter project, to get back into it. And that'll be it. And by the way, happy holidays to everyone, no matter what your faith, religion, or so. I know around this time a lot of religions come together. And although I'm not a very religious person, I do respect the right for everybody to have their beliefs. Thanks. That hurt. Anyways, moving on. Say bye. 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 See ya. Squeak.
My plan was simple. I had to drag myself out of the professor's basement, hitch a ride on a Federation shuttle, get on board a starship, and just once go through the transporter in the hopes that it would reconstitute my decaying genetic structure.
Alright, I'm going to be using my Pache Talon. It's not an expensive airbrush, maybe around $100. And it's a top feed, gravity feed. It's got a terribly leaky gasket down here, but you can still use it. It's kind of nice. You can adjust your depth and all that, although I've never found that overly useful. There you can hear the compressor going. Very nice Pache given to me by a lovely lady who was very kind when I was running low on cash and just sent it to me as a gift. I was very impressed. And over here, let's see, do a little mixing here. That looks about right. A little too thick. It's a good clogger. And see here, get it going. Like I said, this is a quickie. I'm not gonna get too in depth, and this is nothing. This is so simple. I just want you to see how I did each piece. Now, no good one. Cancel that one. Gravity feed, dummy. All right, resume. So, we're going to put a little bit in here. Not too much. These are tiny little things. And almost beyond my ability. And we're just going to give it a mild squirt over. Get rid of that excess up front. Ooh, it's spattering a bit. Not good. Yeah, this one needs to be clean. Now, the chair is basically the same colors, although being all glass around it, I'll be using a different color, like a white, to pronounce the windows like I will on the Jupiter 2. And there's a little hair. We don't want that. And so let's just give it a nice little color. Now, the 3D has a bit of a texture to it, but sanding that is not recommended because you'll get rid of all those surface details. So you kind of have to accept that there's gonna be a little bit of rough texture to it. Same with this little guy. And of course the treads are a different color and all that, but you do all that by hand. And that'll probably finish up as far as the details on the little ships on the table, which it would have been a shame not to paint. Of course, I still haven't figured out how to do the markings on the Enterprise because this thing is tiny. Look, you know, maybe there's something out there I can use. I don't know that one. That one I haven't figured out. So there you go. Now I'm going to do a little drawing and then show you what are the primary colors on these five objects on the table. And we'll go from there. Cool.
Intervene. At that very moment, going through the Piscean system, some raiders attacked the ship.
Well, I always wanted the command chair, but this isn't exactly the way I thought it would be. I fear my trusty communicator isn't gonna cut it. It worked. I'm reconstituted. Unfortunately, it's not exactly where I wanted this to happen, but I'm whole. And now, I'll tell you what, somehow I'm gonna get back to Earth. And Professor, this time, I'm gonna shoot straight. This is the Detroit Nazi promise that my name isn't Wilbur Type Period Trap. I'm gonna get ya. Yeah. What's that? What the hell's that? Oh,
man. All right, so as I was saying, this is the next project I'd like to undertake. It is the, Star Blazer Space Battleship Yamato in 1/350th scale, which is, you know, good size, 3 feet long, maybe a tad more, I'm not really sure. It's a hell of a kit. Every deck has its own circuit board with motors and pulleys and all that for all the little cannons. And I bought this many, many years ago for about $500, and I've seen them from far more lately. This isn't the 1/500, mind you, which is, you know, good size, but not that big. And it's a monster kit. I've seen some guys build it in 30 days. I wish I could. It'll probably take me several months to do this thing. And then the painting's a whole other 50% of the project. Although it's got some pretty basic colors. It's like a red and steels and things like that, but not a huge variety like an Enterprise. So there it is. That's Papa's next project. And let's move on. I'm down here. But I want you to see what I'm doing. So I'm gonna try simply here to unveil what we got here, which is first the Spindrift. That's pretty close to the Italian red, which has almost got a pinky hue. There's our Icarus. The Enterprise is a little delicate, so let's take it easy on that little guy. Ooh. Hopefully nothing leaked. but always hang on to some primary colors so you can touch up after. Don't blow your load, bro. Ooh, risque from the old days. I did zap this side, darn it. All right, see, a little touch up. Sometimes the tape leaves a little seam open, and that's just enough for it to seep in. But you get the general concept. Now, of course, the detailing. And then we'll have a cute little display.
Cute.
So that's it as far as what's up now. It's just a very simple little project. But just to show you, I am gearing up for something here. If I can get the table showing a bit here. Because I'm doing this live, unedited. And the table's got a few tones to it just to kind of give it a wood thing. Man, I wish I actually had this table. This would be a great model building table, my God. Curved like that, that would be awesome.
1 eternity later.
So there you go. There's that wood, sort of a two-tone thing. I will add a little grain in there, but very subtle, because I would imagine this would almost be a solid or a formica top kind of look to it. But there you have it. There's our current little project. It would be cool to add lighting, but it would be very hard to show unless we added paneling on the bottom. Then it's quite possible. I'm thinking about it. So anyways, see you next time. And as you can see, the chimichanga has been saved. So I must take care of this. Have a good one. See you next time. Bye-bye. Thank you.